Welcome to an example on how to multiply whole numbers using base 10 blocks using area. Let's first define our blocks. Here we have a 1 block, sometimes called a bit, a 10 block, sometimes called a long, and a 100 block, sometimes called a flat. For this example, let's model 17 times 15. So we'll model 17 vertically and 15 horizontally. Notice for 17, we have 1 10 block, and 7 1 blocks. And then for 15, horizontally, we have 1 10 block and 5 1 blocks. Notice how this forms a rectangle outlined in red. The area of this rectangle is equal to the product of 17 and 15. So now we'll fill in this area using our base 10 blocks. Notice in the lower left-hand corner here, we can fit a 10 by 10 block, which should be a 100 block. And that would look like this. Notice above the 100 block, we can fit several 10 blocks or longs. We can fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10 blocks, which would look like this. Now looking at the right side of the rectangle, notice how we can fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more 10 blocks in the lower right-hand corner, which would look like this. And then finally, we can fit a bunch of 1 blocks. This is 5 by 7, so we can fit 35 1 blocks in the upper right-hand corner, which would look like this. Now let's find the total area. Our 100 block gives us an area of 100. Here we have 7 10 blocks, or 7 times 10, that would be 70. Here we have 5 10 blocks, 5 times 10 is 50. And here we have 35 1 blocks because this is 5 by 7. So the total area and our product is equal to 100 plus 70 plus 50 plus 35, which gives us 17 times 15 equals 255. Looking at these areas again, these values are actually the partial products of 15 times 17. So let's also take a look at that. To show the partial products of 15 times 17, we can write 17 as 10 plus 7 and 15 as 10 plus 5. To find the product in this form, we would perform repeated distribution, meaning we'd first distribute 10, which means we'd have 10 times 10 plus 10 times 5, and then we distribute the 7 as well, which would give us plus 7 times 10 plus 7 times 5. So let's go ahead and find these partial products and compare it to the area of the rectangle that we built. So 10 times 10 is 100, plus 10 times 5 is 50, plus 7 times 10, that's 70, plus 7 times 5 is 35. The sum of our partial products, once again, is 255. Again, the product of 15 and 17. But if we compare this to our rectangle, notice how the partial product of 100 is equal to the area of our 100 block. The partial product of 50 is the area of our 5 10 blocks here. 70 is the area of our 7 10 blocks here, and then finally 35 is the area of our 35 1 blocks here. So using base 10 blocks to multiply is a nice way to visualize the product and also a nice way to visualize the partial products of a given product. I hope you found this helpful.